The Last Valley is a film by James Clavell. Oh, he actually wrote it and directed it too. I didn't know that. But he has apparently done a lot of stuff without me knowing. I know that he wrote The Asia Saga, which is a series of 5 books about Japan and different time periods. But he also did the Shokan TV show, The Great Escape, To Sir With Love, and The Satan Bug. Anyways, this story is about the captain. He's played by Michael Caine. He and his sort of squad of soldiers find a peaceful valley out in the mountains. And even though the rest of the country is decimated by war and fighting and starvation and the plague, the captain and his band of men find this plentiful valley full of like innocent, sheltered, overly religious people. And the wars are going on between the Protestants and the Christians. And there's also a teacher named Vogel who wanders onto the village on the same day. So he proposes to the captain that they should not tell the army about this wonderful valley because it'll be pillaged and, you know, the food will run out within weeks. Instead, why not just stay here over the winter and just eat and bang the village women? And the captain agrees. So this sort of uneasy peace begins with the villagers. They have a very cunning leader, and they basically create some ground rules for the soldiers to not go around looting and pillaging everything. And this sort of becomes a sort of, shall we say, power struggle, psychological game of cat and mouse. And I wasn't expecting this because when I read the who was in it, I was like, oh, Michael Caine. I like Omar Sharif. But this movie is really interesting because it basically explores the savagery of man and the way that, you know, back in the day, people can do whatever they want to each other. As long as you have more people or more swords or more force, you can pretty much impose your will upon anything you want. And so there's this uneasy peace between the villagers and the soldiers. The villagers would love to kill all the soldiers, but the soldiers could, you know, do a lot of damage. And there's plenty of food to be shared, but there's a sort of uneasiness between all the different characters. So besides the captain, he's also got different characters who oppose him or whatever. And he's an uneasy peace because, you know, all the men, you know, as soon as they offer a mutiny, you know, it's over. So there's a really interesting sense of power struggle between all the different characters. There's many facets of religion also thrown in because there's some characters that are Christian, some are Protestant, some are devil worshippers. There's a lot of interesting elements going on, and I really enjoyed this movie despite, you know, not knowing much about it. There's also a great performance from Michael Caine. He has some great monologues about the futility of war. There's a lot to like in this movie. There's some interesting battle scenes too. They're not too glamorous, but you know, it's one of those hearty adventure stories with a nice brainy touch. So The Last Valley is definitely worth checking out. I definitely enjoyed it. I give it a 7.5 out of 10.